Dissects Cop Dissects Wilson and Gold Star Widow's Stories, Notices Issuost Cops See. The sparring over President Donald Trump's phone call to an American soldier's widow has been an obsession of the mainstream media, thanks to the grandstanding of a Florida Democrat grabbing for a national spotlight. But for a former police officer now working as a commentator for Conservative Tribune, one angle the Trump bashers are missing is just how credible the witnesses to the conversation really are, what the context of the controversy is, and how past actions might come into play. And by any of those standards, in the eyes of retired police officer Brandon Tatum, Trump should definitely get the benefit of the doubt. Tatum, a six-year veteran of the Tucson, Arizona, police, said getting to the bottom of the controversy ignited by Florida Democrat Frederica Wilson's claim that Trump was disrespectful to Mashiya Johnson, the widow of Army Sergeant Law David Johnson, during a condolence call meant putting basic police methods to work. And for Tatum, the fact that Wilson and Johnson's used almost exactly the same words in recounting the phone conversation is grounds for suspicion alone. Liberals and liberal sympathizers might want to say it's proof that they heard the same thing, but to a skeptic, say, to an investigating police officer, it sounds a lot more like they've agreed on a common story. Police officers prefer to interview witnesses separately. These two have been together so much the word collusion doesn't even cover it. Meanwhile, Trump and his chief of staff John Kelly, who was not party to the Trump-Johnson phone call, have a different take on events. Trump maintains he was respectful throughout the conversation and that Wilson is politicizing what should have been a private conversation. Kelly, meanwhile, in a searing statement to White House reporters last week, said he was stunned by how the call had been blown up by Wilson's talking to the media. So, whom to believe? Consider the source, Tatum said. You have to deal with witnesses. When you have two people with conflicting statements, you would have to look at independent witnesses. You have Donald Trump and John Kelly. They work together and have each other's interests. And then you have Frederica Wilson and Sergeant Johnson's widow. They also have each other's interests. She and Wilson are family friends. So, we have conflicting stories here with no independent witnesses to come forward. But we do have audio of what Trump said to another widow who is also African American, and the way he talked to her is consistent with Trump and Kelly's account of what happened this time. No one can know for sure because we don't have the audio, but evidence from the past points to Trump and Kelly telling the truth. That audio was a widely disseminated recording of Trump speaking to Natasha Ailmkar, the Gold Star widow of Army Staff Sergeant Mark R. Ailmkar, shortly after the soldier's death in Afghanistan on April 8. No one listening to that call could describe Trump's bearing as anything other than completely respectful. Listen to it here. "What a horrible thing," Trump said. "Except that he's an unbelievable hero, and you know, all the people that served with him are saying how incredible he was and just an amazing, amazing guy. And I wanted to call you and just tell you that he's a great hero." So, can anyone picture the man who spoke those words behaving like the picture of a callous brute Wilson is trying to paint of the president? That takes care of the witness credibility and past actions, but how about the current context of the dispute? Well, a GoFundMe campaign has been set up under the name of a project started by none other than Congressman Wilson to raise money to pay for the college education of slain sergeant's three children. So far, more than $700,000 has been raised since its creation on October 16. That was one day before Trump placed his call to Mashiya Johnson. Does anyone think the media firestorm Wilson ignited when she went to the media to complain about the call on October 18 has hurt the fundraising effort? By comparison, a GoFundMe page for Staff Sergeant Dustin Wright, who died October 3 in the ambush that killed Johnson, has raised $51,000. Both men are heroes who died serving their country, but one is more than 10 times more deserving of the public's gratitude than the other. Follow the money might be unseemly under the circumstances, but there's a whole lot about the controversy the radically liberal Wilson sparked over Johnson's death and Trump's phone call that doesn't look right. And a policeman's eye can see it. Please like and share on Facebook and Twitter to spread the word about retired cop and conservative commentator Brandon Tatum's doubts about Frederica Wilson.